like Obaseki, like Ambode, three governors who fell out with their political godfathers. Godfatherism, at least in Nigerian politics, did not start today. Over the years, there have been individuals who dictated the tune of how a political office holder plays. These men and women are sometimes not in the limelight, and they prefer to operate behind the scenes, and while some of them operate in the public alongside those they help put in power. Case in point is the ongoing saga between embattled Edo State Governor Godwin Obaseki and his godfather, current chairman of the ruling party, the All Progressive Congress, Adams Osihomole. That tussle has led to Governor Obaseki resigning his membership of the APC. Now, it is still unclear as to how he even wants to go again about his second term in office. Another case that raised a lot of eyebrows was that of former Lagos State Governor Akinwumi Ambode and his godfather, former Lagos State Governor, Governor Bola Ahmed Tinubu. Tinubu's withdrawal of support is what many believed to be the main reason Ambode did not get back into office for a second term in Lagos State. You know, the Jagaban, people say when the Jagaban does not support you, at least for the top job in Lagos State, there's nothing you can do. In today's video, we'll be sharing three politicians whose political career suffered after they fell out with their godfathers. Number one, Chris Ibigi and Chris Uba. In 2003, Chris Uba, who was then a member of the PDP Board of Trustees, was at the apex of his power as a politician and party financier. This was obvious in the way he often boasted that having single-handedly put in position every politician that was in office then in Anambra State. Now, after helping Governor Chris Ndidi get into office, both parties fell out with things coming to an end when Ngige was kidnapped in July 2003 and forced at gunpoint to sign a letter of resignation. This thing sounds like a film, it sounds like a movie. He was a sitting governor, Chris Ngige was a sitting governor, and he was kidnapped at gunpoint and asked to sign a letter of resignation. Now, that resignation was accepted by the State House of Assembly at that time, even though Ngige was later unseated by the court in 2006, we cannot forget that drama in a hurry. Number two, Rashidi Ladoja and Lamidi Adedidi. Chief Lamidi Adedidi was known as the strong man of Ibadan politics, and this title wasn't far-fetched because of how Adedidi ran the politics of Oyo State when he was alive. He is credited with having put Governor Rashidi Ladoja in office. Ladoja was elected governor of Oyo State in April 2003 on the platform of the PDP, and he took office in May 2003. By August 2004, Ladoja and Adedibu were locked in a fierce struggle over allocation of government appointees. On January 2 of 2006, Ladoja was impeached by the Oyo State legislators and forced out of office. His then deputy, Christopher Adebayo Alawakala, was sworn in as the new governor. However, on November 11, 2006, Ladoja was returned to office by the Supreme Court. Even though he went on to lose his bid for re-election for a second term due to Adedidu's efforts. Number three, Abdullahi Ganduje and Rabiu Kwakwanso. Now, this particular story is unlike the two we mentioned earlier, because Abdullahi Ganduje is still in office as the governor of Kano State, so he didn't really lose out in the real sense of the word. However, the drama between Kwakwanso and Ganduje was something that many who were familiar with northern politics won't forget in a while. Ganduje was the deputy governor to Kwakwanso when Kwakwanso was elected governor between 2003 and 2006. Also in 2011, when Kwakwanso won another term, you know, when they were both re-elected. It is still unclear as to what caused the main rift between Ganduje and Kwakwanso, but the build-up to the 2019 gubernatorial elections was when their enmity came to a head, with Ganduje almost losing his governorship. I think some of them tell you he lost the election, but due to some other factors, he was declared governor. But we know for a fact that election, Kwakwanso and his Kwakwansia movement showed him pepper. They literally tormented Ganduje. So guys, like I mentioned earlier, godfatherism did not start in Nigerian politics today. Something has been happening for a while back. This is what I'm asking. Which names do you think we missed on this list? Let us know, guys. Go to the comment section. Tell us which other experience, which other politician lost out because of fights with his godfather or godmother. Let us know, guys.